Hey guys, it's Brokerpers, and welcome back to my favorite 16 Liverpool Chromo, where last time I left off, I defeated Sheffield Wednesday in the league and narrowly got past Aston Villa in the cup, needing a late goal to get me through. Ooh. If you didn't see the last episode, I have no idea what I am talking about. Please go and watch it, because as you will be completely lost on what I just said if you haven't seen the episode. If you have, then you know exactly what I'm talking about, and you might be laughing at me, which, to be fair, considering it took me almost 90 minutes to beat Aston Villa, who in real life got relegated in dismal fashion, I don't blame you. In this episode, as you can see, I have a league game, a very crucial league game against Manchester United, with the hopes of making my gap between me and them, because they're in second, 15 points. Crucially, putting me within 6 wins of the league title, including this would be 7, so right now it's 7, but after this, the gap will be 15 points, and I will only need to win 6 more games at most. Hopefully, Man United might slip up between now and then. Hopefully. I can't guarantee that, but what I can guarantee is that I'm going to kick their ass. Because, of course, if you've been a long-time subscriber to this channel, you know I never lose to Manchester United. In fact, I am undefeated against them through all FIFAs as a Liverpool manager. So, history is on my side, so Man United will have to do something they've not been able to do ever, and that is defeat me as Liverpool manager.
Hello once again, I'm
it's crucial that I say as Liverpool manager, because in other career modes I have lost them.
Manchester United. It's such a
but usually it's in second legs of
30 miles apart.
Yeah, well of course you
European competitions when I've already progressed by having a greater victory through the first leg. I think only once that they overturned it, and that was actually in one of my career modes that is on YouTube, I think. I'm trying to remember which career mode. I think that was my Benfica career mode from FIFA 13. I might be wrong about that.
Starts with Ricardo Rodriguez.
Such a long time ago, 3 years.
Bale starts with Marco Reus in the wide positions. Cristiano Ronaldo plays
FIFA
up
70 now.
Gareth Bale.
Coming out in September.
And in goes the cross. They put that cross far too close to the goalkeeper.
But that is neither here nor there. We are here to
Liverpool will get the throw.
Win another league title. Obviously, I can't win in this match, but I can practically win it in this match.
Gareth Bale.
Because after this, United will have. Well, they already have a really an upskill.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Ooh, mountain to climb in terms of catching me.
And that will be Liverpool.
But being them here and continuing the undefeated streak will
they're grateful for that.
Pretty much make it
intervention like that
insurmountable.
Shots on here.
To the man. Bale, there we go. Gareth Bale. Will be taking his Welsh team into the semi-final against Ronaldo's Portugal in a few days. He's in fact that that semi-final will take place the day after my Thursday career mode video. The final quarter final is on tonight after between France and Giant Killers Iceland. England fucking wish. Iceland were always going to win that match. It's because England were too cocky. That's exactly what happened, and England have no one else to blame.
Putting this attack together well.
That's they see in the mirror when they look in it. And everyone else who was saying that Iceland was pretty much a pushover match. Shouldn't have said that, and that's exactly why they lost. I mean, of all the people that
especially the
right off
for winning the away game,
the so-called underdogs, you think England would have paid, you think the English would have paid some attention to, oh, I don't know, the Premier League, which was won by Leicester City, and ironically a country with about the same population as Leicester beat England. Irony. He doesn't. Isn't even a strong enough word for how ironic that is.
The shot's up. Oh, it's off the bar. He's kept it out.
That's just funny as hell. Can Iceland do the same to France? We'll have to wait and see.
Nathaniel Clyne.
If they do, Iceland might need extra security around their hotel, because the France fans would not be happy if France go out.
Coming up again now, Alan. Another look at Bale's goal. It's given them the lead. Well, it was just struck too hard there for the goalkeeper, even though he got a touch. Couldn't keep it out. Well, the home team are...
I'm sure Chelsea fans were a bit happy to see the elimination of Italy last night, because that means their manager is coming.
Good take by the goalkeeper, but no pressure on him.
Conte, not to be confused with Kante, he of Leicester.
On to Ronaldo,
who was set to join Chelsea whenever he finished up with Italy in the Euros, which, thanks to Germany, was last night, in what was the worst penalty shootout I've ever seen in my life. Like, I thought Liverpool taking penalties against Manchester City were bad, but at least Man City were scoring their penalties. At least they were doing that, but both teams were pretty rubbish in terms of the penalties. I mean, Bastian Schweinsteiger, what in the name of Christ was he doing? I mean, of all the players they could have brought on, I mean, they had Götze, they had Emre Can. I mean, the Germans had so many other midfielding options that could have that would have buried that penalty and finished the Italians off before sudden death. But no. Oh, they brought on Bastian Schweinsteiger, and they got his... And he missed like a fucking chump.
Good defensive play, no cross, and no danger.
Although, to be fair, Germany should have won on the in normal time, but Jerome Boateng, for some reason, decided he wanted extra time and penalties, which is the only logical reason behind whatever the fuck he was doing. I mean, he was like a child in class that had a question for the teacher, or with both hands up. Fucking hell, dumbass. Like, that was, without a doubt, the stupidest thing I've ever seen anyone do.
And setting the ball rolling for the second half, Manchester United.
It was pathetic.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. From this position, they can maybe work something more significant in front of goal from the throw. Morgan Schneiderlin. Young, very good stop.
Oof. Ashley Young just denied by a fantastic save from my keeper. Look at that. Brilliant save. It's a goal kick. Thanks to the brilliant defensive work from Gareth Bale. Which hasn't been seen in a long time because he's not he's not exactly known for his defensive work anymore, is he?
Royce.
I guess it shows that you can take a player out of defense, but you can't take the defender out of the player. Or something to that regard. I don't know. There's Owen Mata, who probably won't be a Manchester United player come next FIFA. Because, especially with Man United signing Henry Mkhitaryan. Henrik, sorry. I'm not sure why I call him Henry.
Eriksen.
But, yeah, that pretty much means that Mata is going to be shipped out it from another club, again, by Jose Mourinho. It's a good thing Man United don't have Kevin De Bruyne, or they'd be losing him as well.
Damian. Royce. Coutinho.
Oh, and I mean, I don't see what Mourinho's problem is with Mata.
He's reached it well.
But it's clear that he doesn't want anything to do with the man.
Save. It's a chance. No, it's offside.
He got rid of him at Chelsea, and he's replacing him at Manchester United. Because Mkhitaryan will probably play over him.
Out of the pitch.
Why Mkhitaryan is giving up Champions League football for Europa League football is beyond me, but I guess that's his priority.
And he bangs it away.
Doing stupid, idiotic things. He must be good friends with Boateng.
Rodriguez.
And why Dortmund accepted such a low bid for him as well. Oh, is confusing as well. I know, you know, with the how badly the pound is going down in terms of value. It's probably worth a lot more in euros, but I would value Mkhitaryan at least 30 something million, not 26 million. Like, I was like, wait, what? Is this real?
To be in front here.
It doesn't seem real that they are paying so little for someone who played very well for Borussia Dortmund.
That's going to run on through to the goalkeeper. Keeping an eye on the time here. We still could have a decisive moment in the short time that remains. Wayne Rooney. This crowd continuing to definitely let their feelings known. Manchester United having to force the play here.
I mean,
time for the Alamo. By the looks,
I don't understand it. Maybe when he signs, he'll reveal why in his interview. And if it's just that he wanted to play under Jose Mourinho, I might just scream. And so if you hear someone shouting at the top of their lungs, do you think, is that someone shouting or am I going crazy? No, that's probably me. Chances are probably be me.
Opportunity now. Cristiano Ronaldo. And a goal.
Cristiano Ronaldo seals the win. And may as well. Seal the title as well. Right in front of those United fans. And I wish there was like a wave celebration where you could have the player wave at the crowd. I should have had him celebrate right in front of the United fans just to rub it in that bit more. And I'll take that Ronaldo has scored for the second league game in against Manchester United. He scored against them at Old Trafford. He scored the second and very crucial goal
when they had the ball
here at Anfield. The gap is 15 points. Manchester United are proverbially screwed.
Well, they have had such a great defense, the home side. And they've
now those Emily hugging everyone. He's like, Rooney gets a hug and Tielemans gets a hug. Everyone gets hugs. The lion himself. Aldo thanking me for something? I'm not sure what he was thanking me about. You're welcome, Cristiano. Ooh, Anderlecht. First time I'm coming up against them in my Liverpool career mode. I'm almost half tempted to play Tielemans against them. Costa's banned? Should I? I'll put him on the bench. And maybe he'll come on. What? You can play Cam, can't you? Yes, you can. Good man. I will start Ibe. Why not? Ozil can come on as an impact substitution. Should I need it? My main impact substitution will... will be Tielemans, though. As he could make an appearance against his former club. First time I'm coming up against him since the career mode began. Only the second time I've come up against him in this FIFA. Of course, I ran into them in around this stage in the Europa League in my Braga career mode, for those of you who remember. Your Tielemans was a big part of me getting past them. Will he make some difference this time around only for Liverpool? The irony would probably not be lost on the Anderlecht lot.
Well, it's the knockout stage in the Champions Cup. The round
if that
of
was
16
to happen,
really hots up from here on in.
I guess we just have to wait and see.
Would hope to step forward and really lead from the front.
Yep.
We can see here how Anderlecht are going to line up. Well, it's 4-4-2 for them.
Is that who I sold him to?
The middle four might be a diamond, Alan.
Yeah, and it gives them a bit of solidity. In the
no, wait,
of the
he was already sold. Holding him for life.
To provide the width in this shape.
I think Fabio Barini is with the Anderlecht team.
Just to check on the formation. 4-4-2, but... And another shot!
Oof! Great save, Dragowski. He is! No F. Barini, frickin' hell. So two players playing against their former clubs. Tielemans might. And Barini is. Fair enough. A little surprise from Anderlecht. Was not expecting that. Ooh! He almost buried one against me. You have to be more careful.
Iturbe.
Would be in one mil.
It's a chance.
You know, try. E for the header next time, D-Walk? Oh, was he offside? It must have been, because I don't recall seeing a foul. Maybe there was a foul that the ref... Wait, that was an That's an easy corner to win. Thank you very much, Anderlecht.
Only in that it's impairing a bit our visibility of the proceedings out there on the pitch.
Yeah, we're nice and dry.
Comes out with a punch to clear the danger.
Give me the ball. Oh, there's Pratt.
Sakala, throw in now.
Pull it. The big Belgian.
And a sharp restart.
And does well against the Belgian team. I have a few Belgians who I want to do well against Anderlecht, namely Divock Origi.
Fabio Borini.
Thanks to Wales is coming back early from New York. Host, having not even gotten 1 minute of freaking game time, unless he played in the quarterfinal. I must admit I didn't actually watch the Wales quarterfinal, so I don't know if Origi came on in that match. I doubt he did though, considering that even when they were 3-0 up against Ireland, they didn't bring him on. They brought on the freaking Benteke. There we go. That's exactly what I wanted from Divock Origi. The Belgian scores against the Belgian team. There's a hint of irony there.
You can see a slightly different viewpoint on it.
Imagine if I won 3-0 and all my goals came from my Belgian players, Origi, Pullet, and Tielemans. It's possible. It pops up every now and again where to go. Oh.
So the first goal.
Be a freaking weird coincidence.
Fabio Borini.
I'm not here to.
That's the way to win the ball back.
Make weird coincidences happen. I'm here to.
Well, the player who really
secure my place in the next stage of the.
Is not available today for the away manager. Alan, he's suspended. That's a blow, isn't it?
Champions League.
He's got a good deal of assists this season.
No, for Coutinho.
Chances out there.
I wonder what that's about.
Quite good for Liverpool. But only quite good. They would have hoped to be in a stronger position, but it could be worse.
Maybe he's
course.
In good form, but he's not even on my bench.
The clock and half-time approaching.
Just ignore the ball. Oh. I think it was Pullet who ignored it.
Yeah, this one was all about power. It was all about the fact that he's hit it first time. That was enough.
Showing the goal again. A swift strike from Divock Origi.
The signal's gone up for 2 minutes.
Terabe. Ibe. What's the challenge? Can I get a second just before the half? Wilson! Origi! Wilson! Oh, you gotta be kidding me! You've got to be freaking kidding me!
That's half time at 1-0.
How did that not go in? He got like 5 blocks in there or some crazy shit.
Well, he played really well, didn't he? And he got himself a goal to put his team ahead.
Talk about. Oh.
5 minutes.
What, putting your body on the line to defend the ball. That brings new meaning to it.
Teams lined up ready to go for the second half of this Champions Cup match.
It's terrible.
A place in the quarterfinals.
A little bit tense.
Four gives away the throw.
The first half might open up now.
Here's Nathan Pollett. It's going in.
Good technique.
Yeah. Jonathan Tah.
On EA Sports, coming soon.
Sanchez.
The English League Cup fixture. Liverpool, they'll be facing West Bromwich Albion away from home.
Yeah, a lot of people have been talking about this one. Looking forward to it.
Poor cross from Sanchez, which is not something he's normally doing. Normally his crosses are better than that.
Very weak challenge.
I guess everyone can have one. Brilliant top corner, 2-0. And the decision to put him in over Hershey Ojo has paid off beautifully.
It's a terrific goal at a terrific time, and it should seal the win.
No hearty mouth time for the player.
And that means I won't be scoring all my goals with Belgian players, because the Englishman was the only Englishman in my whole set of players. First with Wilson and is that it?
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
I might only have two. I will have to get back to you on that. I think I only have two. I know Wilson and Ibe are English.
Stefano Akaka.
This was English. I only have two Englishmen in my whole squad. Which would not fly with the real life rules. Because you have to have a certain amount of English players. Which is why Man City actually kept
the goalkeeper not really tested by
James Milner for as long as they did. Considering how many assists he got at the turn of the year for Liverpool, well, they could have used him. Which is quite ironic.
If you look at the coaching manual, you don't defend.
Now the shot! Bounce back off the post!
Are you freaking kidding me? At the post! Should have been 3-0. I know, my Ojo is English, isn't he? Yeah, he is. There we go. So I have three. That's one better. Oh, it's another fantastic strike from another Englishman. This time it is Samuel Wilson who buries it. And it is 3-0.
To hit it that cleanly from outside the box. Marvellous.
He fights off the challenge, he smashes one, and the keeper is left in absolute no man's land. He is not getting anywhere near that. Yo. I haven't been able to do something like that with Costa. Freaking hell, this is... I might have to start playing Wilson over Costa. Yeah, he might be better.
Stephen Defoe is now with Liverpool.
Who knows? There's Wilson again. He's true on goal. Oh, he'll set up Origi for a 4-0. Oh, Anta Hector out. With 4-0. Oh, they're not coming back from that.
Well, he's doubled up here with his second goal, and he took it.
Wilson again showing fantastic strength to fight off the defender, and sets up a pretty easy goal for Divock Origi to get his second and the fourth of the game. That is fantastic.
Favourite in a match can weigh heavily, expectation and all that. It's not a problem for this team, is it?
No, I think their manager will be delighted, because they've not taken it easily at all. They've given respect to their opponents, but they've shown the class too.
You know, I don't even need Costa Wilson's this good.
4-0 here, and almost time up. What does this mean for their next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against West Bromwich Albion, and they've done pretty well out here.
And I always enjoy playing with Wilson ever since I signed him.
There haven't been any phases in the game where they've...
Arguably, he was a free transfer, just sitting there, and the free transfers... There's this brilliant player just sitting there, no one... I mean, I didn't even have any problems. I didn't have any other teams that were trying to sign him. There's no competition, no anything. Freaking hell, if I might have to sell Costa and keep this guy. This guy's way better.
Crowd maybe expected a bit more, but it's two added minutes.
And Martin Costa, if memory serves me correctly, is the is one of those hidden gems I got from the store.
At that end of the stadium.
Right now.
They're officially seated, although some of them stand. And again, like they always did.
Wilson almost hit a second. And Stephen hammer home my point even more.
These days.
You've done enough, friend. You've done enough. Because as there is the full-time whistle. It's 4-0 on aggregate going into the second leg. Anderlecht will have to pull out a performance that's like no other to match to beat me. And there is no surprise who... Oh! I was going to say he got man of the match. He didn't. Dragowski got man of the match. But best outfield performance, outdoing the man who scored two goals. Sam Wilson was the star of the show today. He a goal and an assist, and all around played one of the best performances I've ever seen from any player or throughout FIFA 16. And considering I'm constantly praising his Stendetta for doing such things. That tells you how well that how good that performance was. Oops. Look, Nicholas, I'm not selling you. You're just gonna have to deal with it. Yeah, I don't care. In the next episode, I will have my games against West Brom in the final of the Capital One Cup to add more trophies to my ever-growing list of them. And I will have a league game against Arsenal, who, if I'm right, are third at the moment. I'll have to check that to be absolutely 100% sure. Champions League? No, that's not what I'm looking for. Piece of shit. Yeah, they're third. By goal difference only, but they are third. I don't think I'll be helping Chelsea out in that matter. Man United did win him, but unfortunately for them, I have a game in hand, which means the gap will still be 15 points. Either that or they're relying on Arsenal. And that's not exactly something my fans like to do. They don't really like the Arsenal lot. And from someone who knows an Arsenal fan, a bunch of Arsenal fans, I know the feeling is actually mutual. saying that no one likes Man United. Anyway, I have been talking long enough, so I will finish off by saying thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more videos very, very soon. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.